Zombie apocalypse.
Okay, so good day everyone. So this will be the primary topic of my discussion to pre-stress concrete design. So we will start from the very fundamental of knowing the course, no? By understanding what are the general principles of pre-stress concrete design. So this will be the very first discussion for such topic since it will be divided into three. So the first is the basic concept method. Okay, so be ready to be neuroticized. Okay, so there are actually three different concepts that may be applied to explain and analyze the basic behavior, okay, of this form of pre-stress concrete. It is important that a designer understand all of the three concepts so that he or she can proportion and design pre-stress concrete structures with intelligence and efficiency. The necessity of knowing the three principles of concrete, it is because it is actually dependent on the way the designer will make the concrete be designed under pre-stress, because there is a common goal of doing this. As much as possible, the elimination of tension value is considered. Otherwise, of course, main objective, smaller compression, okay, and or zero tension. But if there is a value of tension, it should be under tolerable on the condition of crack. That will be covered up with my future video lectures under the same course, no? Pre-stress concrete design. Anyway, so let us try to reveal what would be the first principle that we need to understand. Okay, so let us try to deal with how the C-line method works. Okay, let's say you have this concrete, no, with tendons, okay? Let us have some piece of analogy or a slice of what we are going to analyze, okay? Okay, now this is the actual interaction of the A concept. Now, in your RCD, no, naalala nyo lang that C is equal to P. P pala. So that's why also we consider that T is also equal to P at the pre-stressing force. So therefore, we can safely say that C is equal to T is equal to P. Then again, sa reinforced concrete design ninyo, naaral nyo rin before na pag meron kang ganitong block at meron kang height of compression block, diba ito yung concentration ng C, ibakal ka dito, tension force T, okay? Kasi ito yung effective depth D, yung total, yung distance from the extreme fiber concrete up to the rebar group of tension. So let's say this is a distance of let's say bar A. Sabihin natin bar A. So therefore this becomes D minus bar A. So meaning to say, andito rin yung pala yung konsepto ng pre-stressing. So that's why we can assign D minus bar A as B. Ito. Okay? Yan yung magiging B niya. Tapos yung E is a distance from the CG up to the CGS katulad nung kanina. And A is just a distance from the compression force up to the neutral axis. So don't forget that as we go along with this, dahil iikot dito at iikot yan, may makukumpita yung distance of A. A will be a question. Okay? So ordinarily, kapag ang compression is nasa baba at tataas, no, ng ating compression concrete above CG, so most likely, ito po ay magpa-positive bending. Tama? Kasi compression is above, so therefore, compression is above, tension is below. What type of bending is that? Positive bending. Likewise, if that compression force tends to go below, then it becomes negative bending. So compression below, tension above. So ang ating generation of idea is, mag-assume muna kayo lagi na ang compression force is nasa top of CG. Pag nag-positive yan, tamay assumption. Pero pag nag-negative, mali assumption kasi nasa baba. So all in all, if you started with this concept, then if A is negative or positive muna, then we are realizing positive bending. And if A is negative, as we calculate, then it is realizing negative bending. Anong relation? Pag alam mo positive or negative bending yan, alam mo na ang location ng C at saka ng T, no? Kasi the sign the sign is very crucial, no? Alam niyo pag compression negative at kapag tension positive, pag nilagay natin siya as a stress, yung kanilang sign convention natin. So how do we do that? Don't forget that in your past RCD before na na-discuss at also on my video lectures as included, now we have learned before na merong moment tayong kinukonsider, no? Okay? So let me have a closer look on this. So pag may ganoon kang beam, meron kang C dito, at meron kang tension T dito, di ba, a moment sa T, sabi natin ito yung distance of B, ano? Moment under tension, we can say it is CB. Moment, if we take on compression, it is TB. Okay? But C is equal to T is equal to P. So therefore, we can say this as P. We can say this as P. Also, MT or MC is what you call the nominal moment. So, kahit umikot ka sa tension, kahit umikot ka sa compression, it is what you call the nominal moment. So, we can safely say that the distance of B is equal to the ratio of the moment nominal over the compression force C, where C is equal to P, or T is equal to P rin. So, that's why you can have this generation of equation that A is equal to MT over P minus E. Then, dyan na magde-define kung anong sign na magagamit. And then, po-project ka na dito ng stresses. So, ito, pag yung A mo is negative, meaning, no, negative bending yan. So, pag negative bending, compression is below, tension is above. Okay? Pero kapag yung A mo is nag-positive, sabihin, positive bending, pag ganito po siya, compression, tension. So, ina-assume ng drawing na to is compression is above and tension is below. So, pagka nag-negative, just reverse. Kasi ang pakaliwa sa atin ay compression at ang pakanan ay tension. Okay? And then, you just literally add. So, dito, nagsama na yung tension for, yung stress diagram for bending ng load at saka ng pre-stressing force. Naging dalawa na lang. Kanina sa basic line method, tatlo yan. Naka-separate yung para sa pre-stressing force at saka naka-separate yung para sa load, bending due to load. Okay? So, that's why you're going to come up with the same answer din ng basic concept method. So, thanks for viewing. Please subscribe to my YT channel. Don't forget to hit the like and share button below. And again, as a tradition, you have been neurorized. So, see you in our next video lecture. And the next topic would be the third concept, that is the load balancing method, that we will agree with the theory of structures this time. Okay? So, see you in our next video lecture.